In this video, we'll explore the trade-off between inflation and unemployment. We will use the short-run and long-run Phillips curve to explore the relationship further. The trade-off between unemployment and inflation comes from the fact that measures to boost aggregate demand may cause output and employment to increase, as well as place upward pressure on wages and resource prices. If aggregate demand increases and more people are working, this can lead to demand pull inflation. Overall, unemployment will fall and inflation may rise. I've taken two snapshots from Federal Reserve Bank data on the unemployment rate and inflation. On top is the unemployment rate and the bottom graph is the rate of inflation. The shaded areas represent US recessions. You can see that unemployment often spikes in recessions or just after. As unemployment rises, you can also typically see inflation falling. This covers from just before 1950 to recent times. The data helps to demonstrate the relationship between unemployment and inflation as measured by consumer prices. It should also follow then that measures to decrease aggregate demand may cause output and employment to decrease, as well as place downward pressure on wages. Additionally, it may also result in a fall in the price level. Unemployment will rise and inflation may decrease. If there is a negative supply shock to the economy, such as a sudden rise in oil prices, this can lead to stagflation. Higher costs will result in lower output and higher unemployment. The economy will suffer from higher prices, lower output, and higher unemployment. Now let's turn to the Phillips curve model to understand the relationship between unemployment and inflation visually. The Phillips curve was developed by New Zealand economist A.W. Phillips. The basis of the model is that unemployment and inflation have a stable and inverse relationship. As the unemployment rate increases, the rate of inflation falls. We label the curve SRPC and call it the short-run Phillips curve. The Phillips curve presents policymakers with combinations to target. For example, the red combination of I1, U1 demonstrates a point at which unemployment is very low, but the rate of inflation is high. On the other side, the green combination of I2, U2 represents a point at which unemployment is very high, but the rate of inflation is very low. Now enter Milton Friedman and Edmund Phelps, who challenged this model and said that the government would not be able to permanently lower unemployment at a high rate of inflation. Rather, they argued, inflationary expectations would lead workers to ask for higher wages, and in the long run, the economy would return to the natural rate of unemployment. To Friedman, the long-run Phillips curve, or the expectations augmented Phillips curve, was a vertical line at the natural rate of unemployment, or NRU, in this graph. To understand why this is, let's review the classical aggregate demand and aggregate supply model. You'll recall that in the classical view of economics, the long-run aggregate supply curve is vertical at the natural rate of unemployment, which we will call Y star in the graph on the left. Now let's bring in our aggregate demand and short-run aggregate supply curves. As you can see, our economy is currently in short-run and long-run equilibrium at PL star. If there is a sudden increase in aggregate demand, then the aggregate demand curve will shift rightwards from AD to AD1. This now corresponds to an increase in output from Y star to Y1 and an increase in the price level from PL star to P1. Classical economists argue that in the face of inflation, workers expect prices to increase and thus increase their wage demands. This causes an increase in production costs and shifts the short-run aggregate supply curve leftward, which returns us back to the natural rate of unemployment at Y star at a higher price level, PL2. Let's connect this to the short-run and long-run Phillips curves. I'll use straight lines for the short-run Phillips curve for the sake of simplicity. The price level PL star can be taken across and changed to I1 for the Phillips curve model. We know that unemployment is at the natural rate, and that corresponds to an inflation rate of I1. To make it easier to follow, I'll use the same color dots to indicate relationships. As a result of the increase in aggregate demand from AD to AD1, output rises from Y star to Y1, and unemployment falls. The price level increases from PL star to PL1. We take this across to the Phillips curve, as well for an inflation rate of I2. Any shift of aggregate demand along the original short-run aggregate supply curve can be demonstrated as follows. The blue dots appearing on the diagram on the left correspond to the matching blue dot on the diagram on the right. Now, let's see what happens when inflationary expectations cause a short-run aggregate supply curve to shift leftwards from SRAS to SRAS1. The new price level is PL2, and real GDP returns to Y star, which corresponds to the natural rate of unemployment. We return to the long-run Phillips curve at the natural rate of unemployment at a higher rate of inflation, I3. Let's see what would happen if aggregate demand shifted along any points of short-run aggregate supply curve 1. Again, the corresponding points will match on both diagrams. These three dots look strange standing alone. However, when we see a shift in aggregate supply, we also see that the short-run Phillips curve shifts, almost like a mirror image. If the short-run aggregate supply curve shifts leftward, the short-run Phillips curve shifts rightward. Now let's look at an animation that brings it all together again. So we begin at the natural rate of unemployment, or Y star, on the ADAS diagram, which corresponds to I1 and the natural rate of unemployment with the original short-run Phillips curve. When aggregate demand shifts from AD to AD1, output increases from Y star to Y1, and the price level increases from PL star to PL1. On the short-run Phillips curve, we demonstrate this reduction in unemployment and increase in the inflation rate with point I2, U1. Inflationary expectations cause a short-run aggregate supply curve to shift leftwards from SRAS to SRAS1. As a result, the price level increases from PL1 to PL2, and output returns to Y star. Right, this is mirrored by the short-run Phillips curve as it shifts from SRPC to SRPC1, and the economy returns to the natural rate of unemployment at a new inflation rate of I3. The short-run Phillips curve shift also helps us understand the impact of stagflation. As short-run aggregate supply shifts leftward and decreases, it leads to higher prices and higher unemployment. We see this in the shift of SRPC to SRPC1 and the corresponding increase in the inflation rate from I2 to I3 alongside the increase in unemployment from U1 to the natural rate. Now you try it. Let's start the models at short-run and long-run equilibrium. What's going to happen on both diagrams if there was a sudden fall in aggregate demand? Pause the video here, duplicate both diagrams in your notes, and give it a shot. If you shifted the aggregate demand curve leftwards to AD1, you made the first correct move. On the diagram on the right, we just move along the short-run Phillips curve to a point reflecting the corresponding fall in the inflation rate and rise in the unemployment rate. But we're not done yet. If aggregate demand falls and the price level decreases, demonstrate the impact of the change in expectations of workers on both diagrams. Okay, pause it here, give it a shot. If you've done this correctly, you shifted the short-run aggregate supply curve rightwards to SRAS1, returning to the level of output Y star at a lower price level. You should also have shifted your short-run Phillips curve leftward to SRPC1. If I add in all the labels to make it clear, this is what the final solution would look like. If your answer doesn't look the same, leave a comment below and let's try and figure it out. So by now, you should have a better understanding of the trade-off between inflation and unemployment. If you've become comfortable with the short-run and long-run Phillips curve, then you are doing very well. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below and let's see if we can address them as a community. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.